Hello, I'm Ty Mason of thediabetescouncil.com, researcher, writer, and I have type 2 diabetes. Today I want to talk about what it feels like to have low blood sugar. After you watch the video today, I invite you to check out the description box for my new ebook. This is one of the most comprehensive diabetes meal planning books you can find. It contains diabetes-friendly meals and recipes, recipes for different goals such as 800 to 1800 calories per day meal plans, diabetes meal planning tips and tricks. There are also tons of diabetes-friendly recipes for everyone. Now you may think this is a weird question for a diabetes channel to tackle, but a 2015 study by Dr. Chloe Eldridge found that current evidence shows hypoglycemia is considerably prevalent among people with type 2 diabetes, particularly for those on insulin, yet still fairly common for other treatment regimens. This highlights the subsequent need for educational intervention and individualization of therapies to reduce the risk of hypoglycemia. Now first, let's define what hypoglycemia is. Hypoglycemia happens when the amount of blood glucose, the sugar in the blood, drops to a level that's too low to sustain normal functioning in most people. This is defined as a blood sugar level of about 70 or below. Now, left untreated, hypoglycemia can lead to a coma and even death. It is a very important event, and those with diabetes need to monitor their sugar levels and treat hypoglycemia when it is present and treat it right away. It happens more often than we think. So what does it feel like to have hypoglycemia? Well, let's look at the most common symptoms. There are actually two classes of hypoglycemic symptoms, those that are due to the lack of sugar in the brain, and those that are due to an adrenaline response of your body. You see, when blood sugar levels get too low, the body will signal the adrenal glands to kick in. This also signals the liver to produce more sugar. Now, symptoms of this adrenal response are, as one of the first signs, it will be insatiable hunger. You've eaten, but nothing you eat can seem to fill you up, and you have this feeling, and you just can't get enough to eat. Check your blood sugar immediately. If it's lower than 70, what you need to eat is 15 grams of fast-acting carbs. Now, this comes from a variety of sources. You can try 4 ounces of fruit juice, 6 ounces of regular soda, not diet, about 5 crackers, a tablespoon of jelly or even honey, or about 8 pieces of hard candy. That would help get those 15 fast-acting carbs in your body. Another symptom is the inability to rest at night. Now, this could be due to nocturnal hypoglycemia, and the signs of nocturnal hypoglycemia are restlessness, you make unusual noises, attempting to get out of bed or accidentally rolling out of bed, sleepwalking, having nightmares, or sweating. You may wake up with a headache in the morning. Your blood sugar was so low during the night it caused that headache. Sometimes a snack before bed can reduce the frequency and severity of these sleep disturbances. Some people have a strong feeling of anxiety. Now, this is caused by that rush of adrenaline. This overload of adrenaline in your body can cause some very anxious moments and can also make you feel like you're having panic attacks. If you have uncontrollable sweating, even if you're not hot, that can be a sign of hypoglycemia. This can be one of the very first signs as well. The central nervous system kicks in after the adrenal glands do, and they push that adrenaline through. This causes the autonomic nerve system to issue a sweat order to the skin. Shakes and tremors are another sign of this adrenal push. Because of that adrenaline rush, the central nervous system starts to malfunction. And as a result, it releases chemicals that encourage glucose production and also can produce tremors. Now, there are other symptoms that come from a lack of sugar in the brain. Fatigue can actually fall into both categories. There's a fatigue that can set in after an adrenaline rush, but also a fatigue from the lack of sugar in the brain. Either can be very serious. Emotional instability. If you notice having mood swings and sudden emotional episodes not typical of your normal behavior, well, that's part of the neurological symptoms of hypoglycemia. These could include irrational outbursts or random crying for no reason, which may become uncontrollable, extreme anger without any cause, a strong desire to be left alone. mild mood changes that can be not be as severe, but can be very, very present, would be general irritability or becoming easily annoyed. They can also be a signal that your blood sugar may be dropping. Dizziness and lightheadedness. Now, this is a common symptom as far as the hypoglycemia from the lack of sugar in the brain goes. Your dropping blood sugar can result in fainting. If you feel dizzy, lightheaded, you need to sit or lie down immediately so that you don't injure yourself. Because the brain is especially sensitive to a drop in sugar, you may experience a sense of confusion and an inability to concentrate on one thing at a time. This makes your mind seem to wander all over the place. If your vision suddenly becomes blurry or you see double, a drop in blood sugar may be to blame. This is also a result of the brain's lack of sugar that affects the optic nerve. Your sugar-starved brain may cause you to slur your words. Now, to others, this may resemble someone who's been drinking, but you may not even notice. Now, these lists are not exhaustive, but the more common symptoms of hypoglycemia. And according to WebMD, some people have no symptoms of low blood sugar at all. The only symptom you may have is confusion, or you may become unconscious before anyone realizes that you actually have low blood sugar. You may have hypoglycemic unawareness if you cannot tell the symptoms of your low blood sugar, or you have low blood sugar several times a week, if you have type 1 diabetes or have had type 2 diabetes for a very long time. If you have hypoglycemic unawareness, you need to test your blood sugar often, especially before activities like driving a car. It's also a good idea to keep a quick sugar food with you. If you take insulin, carry a glucagon emergency kit. You can also have friends and family instructions about how to treat your low blood sugar. I hope this has given you a full understanding of what hypoglycemia is and how it feels. Don't forget to get my ebook and please subscribe to our channel for many more videos like this one in the future. Thanks for watching. I'm Ty Mason.